Mono Lake is a salty and alkaline lake in northeast California. The streams which feed Mono Lake from the eastern Sierra Nevada mountains are a source of fresh water to Los Angeles, 300 miles south. Combine this with a recent drought, and the lake undergoes drastic biogeochemical changes. Mono Lake is home to algae called picocystis. When water is diverted, the water level drops, making the lake saltier and increasing the alkalinity. Suddenly, we see a natural algal bloom and the lake turns bright green, a process known as eutrophication. During these unusual conditions, doctors John Spear and Frank Corsetti and a team of graduate students participating in the International Geobiology Course came from around the world to learn more about the lake's changes in a collaborative effort of research to better understand the lake. The team sampled the lake by a water column transect from the surface down to the bottom sediments at 25 meters underwater. Occasionally, the scientists battled tough conditions on the lake, including high winds and beating waves. But why all this effort? Picocystis algae are the main food for Artemia monica, a brine shrimp, the dominant animal in the lake, as there are no fish. It's too salty. The lake is normally a feeding ground for migratory birds, snapping up the defenseless shrimp. However, during algal blooms, Artemia struggle under the hypoxic conditions. This throws the ecosystem off balance. Understanding these population dynamics is important for the whole food chain. Secondly, picocystis gets its energy from photosynthesis, which requires light and releases oxygen. When eutrophication clouds lakes, they become dark and hypoxic, and anaerobic organisms thrive. However, the scientists discovered something odd. Samples were returned to the lab where DNA was extracted and sequenced. The data was processed to list all the organisms present in the samples at each depth. Despite almost total darkness, picocystis was still present deep in the lake, near and in the sediments. There were also aerobes, microbiota that need oxygen to survive. This could mean that picocystis was producing oxygen and changing the microbial composition of the lake. After the bloom subsides, these remarkably tolerant algae could be what allows the microbial composition of the lake to remain intact, serving as a seed bank of microbiota for the overall health of Mono Lake. Further investigation by Drs. Alex Sessions, Victoria Orphan, and Woody Fisher with future geobiology course students into the photosynthetic properties of picocystis could help provide solutions to the management of Mono Lake, but also eutrophication damage worldwide. This type of research also provides students worldwide with the opportunity to collaborate, consider geobiology through time, and be inspired by unique ecosystems. Water availability is an increasingly critical issue in this time of climate change, and educating young people about safe and practical water management is essential for the future.